Hello, and today we're with Dean Cid, who is the General Manager of Microtel Mall of Asia. Good afternoon to you, Dean.
Good afternoon, Stephen.
Now, here we are. We're at the ASEAN Tourism Forum 2015. How is the show going for you here in Myanmar?
Well, we have met several of their buyers that are interested to promote the Philippines. And what surprises them is, since we're a hotel group in the Philippines located in different areas, they're happy because they can just talk to one outfit and that can support them all throughout the Philippines.
Now, Wyndham is one of the biggest hotel companies in the world.
Yes, yes. In terms of number of hotels.
Right. In terms of the Microtel, where does that fit into the brand?
For Microtel, it's a limited service in the mid-market category. So we focus mostly on the budget travelers, those even in the corporate segment, those are those who are really not focused on staying in big hotels, run on the budget. So we are right smack into their line of accommodation.
How do you describe the rooms that you offer to travelers? They're not luxurious, obviously.
Yes.
How do you describe the rooms?
We provide the basic necessities of a traveler: clean, comfortable beds, hot water, no frills. We don't put the mints in your bed at night. It's just basically a good place to stay, have good sleep, and a hearty breakfast in the morning to start your day.
Right. Now, you're GM of the Microtel and Mall of Asia. Just briefly tell us a little bit about that property. How many rooms does it have, and is there different categories within those rooms?
Yes, it is our flagship property in the Philippines. It is our biggest so far, 150 rooms, very near the international airport of Manila. We are also in a development. We're next to the biggest mall, which is SM Mall of Asia in the Philippines. We are surrounded by a nice convention center, an events place, which is the arena where you held sports events, concerts. We are also into the BP, the business processing outsourcing offices. So it's really a nice development. You don't need to go out of it, no, to experience everything.
Who are staying at your hotel? What nationalities are staying at your hotel at the moment?
Our nationality mix is 60% of the domestic market, 40% foreign, mostly Americans, Australians, Japanese, Chinese, and even Koreans and Singaporeans stay with us.
In terms of the average room rate, what sort of average room rates are you able to get, and what are your occupancy rates for 2014?
For Mall of Asia, it's our highest performing in terms of occupancy, 85% year-round, average rate of about $100. In terms of our chain, we're about 70% chain-wide in occupancy.
In terms of technology, because a lot of these new budget-style hotels are utilizing technology to reduce costs, mm-hmm. and outsourcing as well, how do you use technology? For example, things such as online check-in or kiosk check-in, are these the things that you're looking at and exploring, or are you staying with the traditional?
We're still into the traditional. Yes, we're also looking to how we can improve the efficiency of our check-in. In terms of technology, definitely all our hotels are hooked into the into the internet, no? Because even our guests in Mall of Asia, 34% book through online either through our website, online travel agencies. No? So the internet is really giving us good business for us.
In terms of the as a group within the Philippines, where are the other properties located, and which, for example, from an international traveler perspective, are the most popular?
For us, we already have three in Metro Manila. Before, we were not really concentrating on Metro Manila. Our focus is into the province, because before, it's hard for you to get good accommodation outside of Metro Manila. So that was what we would like. But Manila, we cannot ignore anymore, so even the domestic market is increasing. So we are present in 13 locations already. We have three in our North Luzon island, which is in Baguio, Tarlac, Cabanatuan. In Manila, we are present in Mall of Asia, Acropolis, and Quezon City. Down in South Luzon, we have in Santo Tomas, Batangas, Cavite, and even in Metro Santa Rosa, wherein the industrial parks are. We have two resorts in Boracay and in Puerto Princesa. And then we have two in Mindanao, General Santos and Davao.
For the international travelers, which would be the most popular?
Because for international markets, definitely Manila is one because that's the gateway to the Philippines. We have two resorts, Boracay and Puerto Princesa, where the leisure market are. Even our Batangas property, because it's inside an industrial park, Japanese engineers are our frequent guests there, long-staying guests. So these are our best perform. Even in our what we call Baguio property, it's a mountain resort, but it's mostly domestic market. Foreign, yeah, we have a little bit Europeans who go to the Banawi Rice Terraces.
In terms of the development of the group, do you have any new hotels coming online this year and next?
Yes, we're expanding in Mall of Asia, another 195-room tower. We're into going into Coron in Palawan and in El Nido, Palawan also.
When will the 195 rooms at the Mall of Asia, when will they
be finished? It will be online early in 2017.
Yes. And does that affect the guests at the moment? This is a new build construction, yeah. Is it?
We're looking into bringing in a new Wyndham brand, which is called Trip by Wyndham, to distinguish itself from Microtel Mall of Asia.
Is that going to be the first trip by Wyndham in the Philippines?
It will be. Hopefully, it will be our first trip in the Philippines.
And how do those two brands differ?
Trip is a little bit more on the hip market, younger design, so it gives us more flexibility in terms of the room rates. So it's for what they call for the Generation Y market.
Do you not feel that sometimes it gets all a little bit too confusing, all of these different brands? That really, budget travelers, we just want a good rate, a good bed, a good shower, an electronic safe in the rooms, and quality internet. Mm-hmm. Do you not feel that all of this niche marketing is getting a little bit confusing?
For us, we're still really focused on that. We were the first company who pioneered the budget hotels in the Philippines. So other big Philippine companies are also going into our market now.
In terms of the airlines, you are reliant on the airlines bringing you the guests that stay at your hotels. Where would you like to see airlines such as Philippine Airlines or Cebu Pacific regionally and PAL long distance? Where would you like to see them starting to fly to that they don't possibly at the moment?
I guess for the Philippines is for us to be back in the Europe, for the European markets to have an easy access to the Philippines. Because right now, at least Philippine Airlines already started their long-haul flights to London, so I think they're going to develop other areas as well. They're into both Pacific and Philippine Airlines now are into the Middle East, so it's still a new gateway for us, so Middle East to the Philippines makes it more accessible. In terms of regional markets, flights to Coron and El Nido are really extremely very high. So I think that's one area that we should they should concentrate. Maybe infrastructure is one problem, airport. So the Philippine government should also help in the infrastructure side.
Right. The targets of the Department of Tourism of the Philippines and the Department of Tourism of one of your neighbors, let's say Thailand, is very different.
Yes.
Of course, they have land borders, which makes it a little bit easier possibly to get higher visitor arrivals. Mm-hmm. But what do you think is holding the Philippines back? How would you like to, of course, there's so much to do and see in the Philippines. What do you think it's holding it back slightly against some of its competitors in the region?
I think infrastructure makes it more harder for the Philippines to be accessed by different countries, so it makes it the price makes it higher. Like for example, as I mentioned in El Nido and Coron, for you to fly in, it's easier to fly to Hong Kong from Manila to Hong Kong. Manila to Thailand is more cheaper to go to Hong Kong and Singapore than to places like, let's say, good places like El Nido, even in Batanes up north. You can imagine the airline rates are really expensive. So I think that's one area that our government should support by doing the infrastructure, airports, you know, even land travel. I think that's what's holding the Philippines right now.
Your hotels are all over the Philippines. You've mentioned some new developments coming online as well. For those coming to the Philippines for the first time, where would you recommend your top favorite three destinations within the Philippines? Where would you tell them to go to?
I guess for one, Vigan is really going to be the, it's a nice place, heritage sites. So definitely Boracay because of the best beach. It's the best beach in the world, and definitely Manila. It's something else for you to see. There are a lot of to see in Manila, not only shopping, but also, let's say, in the walled city of Intramuros. It gives the old Spanish feel, and even old Manila, Chinatown. It's a nice place to go.
Excellent. Well, on that, Dean, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and Microtel by Wyndham and Trip by Wyndham eventually the best of luck in the future in the Philippines. Thank you.
Thank you, Steven. Thank you.